First on Fox, more secret evidence is coming to light after a jury convicted a man for stabbing his wife 55 times. It's evidence the jury did not hear, and it's now being revealed by the convicted man's attorney. Fox Files investigator Chris Hayes has the exclusive.
Sandy, it's in this 11-page court motion asking for a new trial. Defense attorney Joel Schwartz hopes to get suppressed evidence in front of another jury soon.
100% in my mind, the wrong person is in jail.
A Lincoln County jury convicted Russell Faria for stabbing his wife, Betsy Faria, 55 times. She died in her Troy, Missouri home 2 days after Christmas 2011.
I mean, 25 years, I've never seen a prosecution like this.
Attorney Joel Schwartz said prosecutors would never pin down a time of death.
It was clear in the state's case and in the closing argument of the state that everything still remains a guess and simply remains a guess because it's virtually impossible for him to have done this.
Russ Faria called 911 at about 9:40 the night of the murder. He claimed he just returned home from his friend's house in Lake St. Louis. During the trial, prosecutors appeared to be leaning towards accusing Russ of killing his wife right before he called 911. But then closing arguments brought a twist.
It was a complete surprise to us because none of it was in evidence, none of it was ever disclosed, and none of it was supported by any shred of evidence at all.
The state alleged that Russ killed his wife an hour or two earlier, during the time four witnesses testified he was with them in Lake St. Louis. Russ's cell phone also pinged in the area of his alibi during the time prosecutors say he killed his wife. Schwartz cannot explain the jury's decision to convict, but thinks it's partly because jurors were not allowed to hear other evidence involving the last person reported to see Betsy Faria alive, Pam Hupp. The jury was not allowed to hear that Hupp currently controls the deceased Faria's life insurance proceeds of $150,000. The jury was prohibited from hearing court testimony that Hupp was still in the area of the murder when she told police she was home. Hupp's cell phone reportedly pinged there at 7:27. Meanwhile, the victim, Betsy Faria, failed to pick up important phone calls she was expecting from her daughter at 7:21, then again at 7:26. Betsy failed to pick up again at 7:30. Attorney Schwartz noted jurors did not hear about Hupp's glaring changes and inconsistencies in the court record, like when Hupp first told police that she had not gone into the house and then stated that she had gone into the house, specifically the living room and the bedroom, rooms where police found murder evidence. Also in the court record, quote, Ms. Hupp told the officers that when she left, Ms. Faria was curled up on the couch, then reportedly amended her statement, saying she last saw Ms. Faria waving from the front door.
The Lincoln County prosecutor was out of the office today, but just told me by phone there was a ton of evidence that she could not use and that she wouldn't have tried this case if she didn't believe Faria is guilty. And also the attorney general joined her in trying this case.
So any comment from Pam Hupp? Have we heard anything from her?
Not since the first day of trial when she said she might talk, then never showed up again, and then she didn't call me back today.
All right. Chris, thanks so much. New information about...